Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the podcast. My name is Anthony Carranza. Today we're meeting with a guest named Daniel Pham. He's going to be talking about this book, Vincent and Theo. Go ahead and introduce yourself, Daniel.
Hello there. My name is Daniel Pham. And as Anthony had said, I will be talking about Vincent and Theo, the Van Gogh Brothers by Deborah Heligman.
All right. Well, thank you for being with us, Daniel. Do you think you could give me a brief summary of Vincent and Theo?
The book had summarized it really well in the back. With the review, without Theo, there would be no Vincent. The book goes over the many letters that the brothers had sent to each other, which is 658 pages, which is quite a lot, really. It goes over like Vincent's origins, from his siblings, what his life was like, how he was raised, and how he became the man that we all know.
Really, 658 letters. That must have been a lot to put in the book.
Honestly, I truly wonder how Heligman had gone through so many letters. She even included paintings and like mini sketches by Van Gogh.
Wow. So what did you think of the book overall? Like, did you have any strong feelings?
I thought the book was a really good read. As someone who like grew up really interested into the arts and learning about like Vincent Van Gogh's painting styles as a child, it was really interesting to see what trials he had gone through as a child into adolescence.
Can you describe like his struggles that he had?
He had really struggled with himself to find what it really meant to be himself. That's probably why he expressed himself so much through paintings.
Did he tend to kind of, I'm trying to think of the right word for this, confide in Theo?
Definitely. The brothers had a really close bond with each other.
So they're really close then. Would you say the story was character-driven or plot-based?
Really, it's character-driven. It's more like a reflection on Van Gogh's life and his journey through it, really.
So, last question, just to finish up the show. How would you recommend this book to others?
This book would be an amazing read for you if you're really interested into the arts or fascinated with the history of art in general.
Okay. Would you consider reading more from this author?
Definitely, if she had similar stories like this one.
Okay. Well, thank you for being on the show today, Daniel. We loved your summary, and we hope you'll be on here again.
Thank you for having me.